Hello there, this is Miriam, holistic life coach and mind body practitioner at Pain Outside the Box. And today I'm going to be discussing how to create healthier neurological pathways in order to replace fear-based pathways and feelings of depression and anxiety, which, as some of you know, can also lead to chronic mind body pains. So this video is based on the assumption that you have some idea of the fact that chronic pain can result as a consequence of deep emotional distress and can get worse when you start to fear the symptoms, when you start to feed the symptoms with more negative attention and more fear. When we do that, when we obsess about symptoms, we are actually reinforcing pain pathways. We are reinforcing the connection between that unpleasant sensation, okay, and our brain. So our brain becomes more able to keep on reproducing that sensation because we start to expect it, we start to anticipate it and predict having it. And sometimes we do this unconsciously. Some individuals are conscious of doing this all the time. So they're conscious that whatever they're doing, whether they're out on a walk, whether they're at home, they're constantly monitoring their symptoms. They're constantly judging them, focusing negatively on the symptoms. And this doesn't help. In fact, it makes everything worse because it reinforces those neurological connections. So what is the way out of this? The way out of this that I'm going to be discussing in this video is to create alternate pathways. It's to change focus bit by bit so that one can let go of that continuous rumination and judgment about the negative present state that one is in. And by the way, we also have to recognize that besides our negative attention on symptoms, typically, we also tend to put negative attention and indulge in negative feelings about other situations in life. I'm sure many of you can resonate with this. Many people, for example, love to comment negatively on Facebook posts. They kind of love to express their opinion in these harsh, rigid ways. They love to get angry about things. I mean, social media is full of anger and rage these days. And we tend to involve ourselves a lot emotionally as we watch the news, as we realize how unfair things are, as we comment, as we share this rage with others. And I've come to believe that no matter how right we are in getting angry, and no matter how valid those emotions are, continuing to express and engage in them, making it a habit of commenting negatively, is actually toxic to the individual. It creates toxic feelings that affects your body overall. I'm not saying that you shouldn't acknowledge rage or anger or frustration if you're triggered in your day-to-day life. What I'm saying is that it shouldn't become a habit to negatively focus and look out for things to be angry about. Now, if that means being on social media less or watching the news less, then so be it. At the moment in my country, there's been a scandal. There have been politicians who have been accused of criminal involvement and fraud. You can imagine how angry a lot of people are. And it's not to say that, you know, they shouldn't have been exposed, not at all. But personally, I have chosen to detach a little bit from involving myself in that anger. I mean, there is the justice system or whatever else, other systems that are dealing with this, which is good. But we have to take care of ourselves, because no matter how justified we are in feeling angry, no matter how, you know, how bad someone else has behaved, if we are constantly indulging in these toxic emotions, we are doing harm to our own bodies at the end of the day. We have to recognize that. So if we want to pursue health, especially if you're already prone to chronic pain, anxiety, and depression, then you have to be aware of this. Where you place your attention, you place your energy. So you have to start by placing your attention on more positive things, on things that can give you more peace, more relaxation, and more joy. So one way of dealing with this is, for example, through active meditation, which is simply to maybe just go outside and be present with your surroundings. Maybe do some grounding. Maybe a short meditation to be with whatever there is, to be with your body. Maybe just even listening to the sounds of the birds outside, you know, taking a moment to notice these little things. And it's okay if these little things don't bring you particular joy or fun. It's okay, as long as they redirect you away from the negative rumination, even for a few seconds, they will start to work for you. So other ways of indulging in positive focus is, for example, to pursue hobbies that you have neglected, to start connecting more with friends or family, have a drink outside, go out more often to the park, to the garden, to the countryside. The outdoors part in particular can bring huge benefit as you immerse yourself in the sights and sounds and smells. All right. It is relaxing the nervous system. There are many ideas and you have to find those that work best for you. And it's also important not to overwhelm yourself with these activities if you've been living a limited life, right? To start gradually with the things that you feel are easier for you, that you feel slightly interested in. And I use the word slightly interested because I know that there are a lot of people out there who have lost the joy, who are not motivated by the idea of resuming their hobby, of resuming an activity, of meeting other people. They don't feel like they have no motivation. That's usually due to the depression or to the anxiety around getting symptoms during these activities. But you have to start somewhere. It's okay if you do not feel overjoyed and exhilarated as you used to be when you were younger or before you had symptoms. It's okay not to feel overjoyed and exhilarated, but still think of these activities that you can resume, that you can pursue bit by bit, right? And repeat them as often as you can. Bit by bit, your brain will start to enjoy them. You will start to notice and appreciate things more and more. But you have to practice these pathways first. It's like learning to drive a car, right? In the beginning, you don't know anything, and then things start to come to you naturally, okay? And it's the same thing. The interest, the curiosity, the fun will result naturally. Not when you're actively looking for it, okay? But eventually, as you repeat and as you focus your attention on more pleasant things, on more pleasant sensations. So do yourself a favor, start somewhere. If the easiest thing for you sounds like a walk around the block, start with that and repeat until you feel that you can be more present with that activity, until you start to get more interested, until you start to look forward to it a little bit more. If you really feel it's not for you, then change it around. Choose something else that gives you more motivation or drive. But as I said, you don't have to feel super motivated. You just have to start somewhere, okay? And then the fun and the pleasure and the relaxation will come as a consequence. So ask yourself, do you have enough activities that you enjoy in your daily or weekly life? What did you used to enjoy before, when you were younger, when you didn't have chronic pain or depression, that you can resume? I mean, for me, one of them was simply reading a book. I had stopped reading books. I had lost interest when I was depressed. But I thought for a moment once, like, you know, I used to enjoy this. Maybe I can learn to enjoy this again. And indeed, the first couple of times that I read a few chapters, I didn't feel so motivated. But as I picked a book that gave me the most fun and was the most absorbing for me, I started to gain interest bit by bit. And then there was another book and another book. So sometimes we have to cultivate interest and motivation, right? It doesn't come just like that, especially if you spend years in a certain fear-based mindset, right? In a state of low mood or depression. It takes time, but I encourage you to just brainstorm and think about the next thing you can resume. Do not postpone activities until you feel perfectly okay in your body. It doesn't happen that way. You will feel better as you start to re-engage in life, as you start to create more positive focus that will replace eventually the negative focus that you've been cultivating and creating. So with that said, I leave you to your own personal reflections, and I'll see you again next time. Bye-bye.